All right, I think we're live. Are we live? Yes, we are live. I'm not hearing anything. So I am live on Instagram and YouTube. This is a John Owen quote. I haven't done anything from him in a while. There we go. Now I hear the music. Hello, as official. That's from Instagram. Thank you. Sorry, I guess I wasn't prepared to go live. I should have gotten everything figured out before I went live. So I just finished inking this comic last night. Charles Spurgeon. I will probably have Stephanie or one of the kids lay in all the flat colors for me, and then I'll go in and do the shading and highlights and all the touch-up work. This one's kind of a heavy one as far as the subject matter goes. He that would be saved by Christ and not ruled by him shall not be saved by him at all. We are to receive a whole Christ, not by halves. John Owen, from the works of John Owen. So before doing all the inks, I go through and just make sure the drawing is structured as well as I want it, and just make sure proportions are right and everything, and I do that with a sketch brush, a pencil sketch brush. Even though it's digital, I still like the look and feel of sketching with a pencil. And so that's what this bottom layer is the pencil sketch layer. Even though it doesn't feel like a pencil, I don't know what it is. It's just that the look just gives me the feeling like I'm working with raw materials or something, and I don't know. It's just nice to get back to that every once in a while. Which is why I like to, occasionally, I like to do the inking work on actual paper with brush pens, micron pens, real pencil. Although the pain comes when you have to erase the lines from the pencil. I'll do that after I ink, and sometimes it'll erase or just fade away some of the ink lines that I put in, which is never fun. Because then I have to go back in with the ink brush and figure out which lines need to be redone. Shoot. Oh, I was gonna say, I thought I had already inked him. And that. Oh, that's right. That's what I was gonna do. Do these all in separate layers. I'm going to do separate layers just in case I want to make it into like a motion comic or something. So I've been reading Spurgeon's All of Grace book, and I figured while I'm reading it, might as well record myself reading it and make it available for people on YouTube. So that'll be coming out on Monday, the first chapter. I don't have the greatest reading voice, but hopefully it'll be helpful for someone. How's everyone's Saturday going? We took the family. Family, which is me, my wife, and four kids. Oh! Hold on. I just spilled my iced coffee on my keyboard. Yeah. Oh no! I may have just deleted. Everything is getting ruined. Okay. Undo. Oh. Cancel. There we go. Oh, that was awful. I didn't think I talked with my hands, but I guess I do. Anyways, we took the family on a bike ride this morning. We went almost 12 miles, I believe. was good exercise, a good bike ride. Finding all kinds of trails in our town here. Yeah, it's just fun to see where we can go straight from our house. We have this trail system called the Ice Age Trail, and it goes all throughout Wisconsin. And there's a bunch of trailheads in our town here that hop onto it. And so we just rode those. Found other ones. It was fun. It was hot. Supposed to get up to like 95 today. But the kids did good. And nobody really complained until we were getting close to being done. I have one of those trail along bikes that we put our youngest on, and she just rides right behind me as I pull her, and sometimes she forgets to pedal, so it gets a little tough sometimes. Her sister usually rides her bike behind us, and she'll remind the younger one to keep pedaling. Okay, let's try to take a drink without spilling all over my keyboard. Success! Woohoo! Man, I'm surprised this thing still works with all the stuff I've spilled on it. Someone out there is probably horrified that I actually drink and eat at my keyboard. Plug in my iPad real quick. It's almost dead. There we All right, so now we have this. I can take off the inks or the sketch layer. There we have it. That's a pleasant image, isn't it? And do this. I'm gonna put all my ink layers together. That. Okay, I'm gonna. Oh, actually, what I'm gonna do is save this. I'm gonna save it as a Photoshop file. Export to RefToons. Just put it in there. Okay, then I'm going to open up my other illustration program. Now we're going to go into Clip Studio Paint here, and if I can get there. My mouse is like going crazy. There we go. Quit that. Open Clip Studio Paint. Wait for that to go. How's everyone doing? The Westminster Catechisms should be showing up pretty soon. Actually, what is today? The 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th. The print company should be shipping them in 5 days. If they're still on schedule. Last time I talked to them, they said they were laminating the covers because it's a hardcover book. They're laminating the covers, and then they are making sure all the text is in place and making sure they have everything right as far as which pages are printed on which paper. Let's see. Now, gonna open this one. Now, I don't know why. I have two monitors here, and this program always opens in the wrong monitor. So, here's what we have here. This is Clip Studio Paint. So now I have to go in here. I have to click Desktop on Display 1. Desktop on Display 2. There we go. Then I always have to zoom to my window here. I don't know what's up with that, but that's what I have to do. Okay, so these are all my ink layers over here, and I want to put a color layer under that one. I'm gonna use yellow for this text box. Oh, I guess I have to probably turn off the under layers. There we go. So which one was that? This one. So there's yellow. And you make a new layer here, yellow. And make a new layer here and yellow. Now that's too yellow. Let's bring that down a bit. Oops. Oh great, now it's gonna color the whole page. Oh no, it's not. There we go. A bit more of a faded yellow look. Even that might be too much. Let's make it a little more browny yellow. Like that. There we go. Like, almost like parchment or something. Okay, group those layers somehow. Oh, this one I have to do. So, again, I wouldn't do this normally. I wouldn't, like, do all these coloring separately. But for this one, I'm gonna try doing, like, some sort of motion comic once I get it all colored. So that's why I'm separating everything into layers. Yeah, I don't know if I'll do any motion with this. I'll just keep this how it is. So let's add some color to this one. Something overflowed into there. It's all right, fix it later. And I'm just laying in some basic colors right now. Get a little more blue. There we go. Alright. And on this person, it's not working right. So that means to fill in that little gap there. There we go. Make it a little darker. Alright, now I go in and just fill in all these little cracks here that didn't get filled in. I found this to be a quicker way of doing the flats, quicker than what I used to do for this. And it's nice, I have this button on my pen programmed, I guess. This button on my pen programmed to select colors. So when I'm doing something like this, it's easy just to click, select a color, and then it switches right back when I let go to my pen tool or whatever tool I was using. And so I can select this color. Hold on. I hate when my toolbar comes up down there. So I can select that color and start drawing. This color, start drawing. This color, start drawing. Super easy. Barely an inconvenience. Had to. So this makes coloring a whole lot quicker. Oops. Grabbed the wrong color there. Yeah, until I mess up and grab the wrong color. We are excited and terrified to travel down to the Sing conference in September. Excited because I think it'll be fun. Terrified because I will be pulling my travel trailer behind me. We're staying at a campground nearby. Actually within walking distance of the place. Which will be nice. I've never pulled my camper that far before. That's why I'm terrified. We just bought it this summer. I'd say this is getting done pretty quick. Find where this logo is so we can do it off. There it is. Ah! That's fine. This should be up here. Top. Finding white spaces here and filling them in. All my chocolate syrup sunk to the bottom of my cup. What is your favorite Bible story? Excuse me. I'm trying to think of what mine is or would be. Oops, what in the world? What's going on? We've been, as a family, we've been reading through the Old Testament. We're on 2 Chronicles right now. It's interesting to see how 1 and 2 Kings is kind of expanded, like a lot of the different stories from there are kind of expanded on and explained in Chronicles. Still have to add all the rain in this one. Just trying to find the right pencil to use. The James Huang. Thank you. Appreciate it. Hope you're doing well. Thanks for joining the stream. I'm gonna switch programs again on us. Why is my, toolbar with all my applications keeps hiding on me. All right, switching over from Clip Studio Paint, which I like to use just to do the flat colors. Switching over from that to, to Affinity Photo. In order to finish up some of the colors here. I'm seeing some white spots that I missed. JC on Instagram. How you doing? Oh. I was trying to figure out what the last part of your name said. JC is king of all. Okay, I get it. I was gonna try to pronounce it "is king of fall" or something. Hello, Sweet Bert Jr. What's up? All right. Affinity Photo is open. And we will bring that down in just a second here. Oh, I just need to save this. Close it. Quit Clip Studio Paint. Bring Affinity Photo down here. File. Open recent. There we go. Oh, what? No. Oh, duh. It's not the one I had opened. File, open. I need to get the Photoshop file. Wait, where is it? There it is. All right, there it is. Look at that. It's still intact. And I'm actually going to take that off. Ah, Sweetbert Jr. says, I'm from Rwanda. Well, hello. Welcome to the stream. I'm from Wisconsin. Oh, my shoulder is killing me. I was in the process of laying in some of these shadows. Turn the tolerance down to 5. That. There we go. I'm going to grab a different brush here and go for blue. Blue shadows are going to give it that cold feeling, I think. Or so they say. I'm just gonna lay these in here. Just kinda guessing at where some of that lighting is gonna come from. Probably be okay just to cover that whole thing here. Okay. Since I have all of that skin color selected, I'm just going to go over and color all of these. Contrast, so I'm gonna turn that down a little. And yes, I realized I didn't color his beard here, but I'll get to that. It's probably the quickest I've ever gotten a comic strip done. These usually take me like 5 or 6 hours or so. But I'm trying to work fast. I feel like I need to catch up on making new tunes. I've been recycling a lot of the old ones. I'm not making new ones because I've been super busy with work. And I just picked up a huge project that's going to take up quite a bit of my time, but it's kind of RefToons related because it's an illustrated version of John Calvin's Institutes. So I'm just working on a promo page for that, just to see if it's a direction we want to go. Is it too blue? It's okay. Time is never on our side here. So I'm just working fast. If you're wondering what the music is from, and you're listening on YouTube, the music is from a website called StreamTunes, S-T-R-E-E-M, Tunes, T-U-N-E-S. I also occasionally use music from StreamBeats. It's all royalty-free music that is safe to use on your live videos without getting a copyright strike. That's why I use it. Alright, let's do this. So I'm gonna use a different brush for this. Not quite sure how I'm gonna approach doing the water, but let's just jump into it and see what happens. Turn the opacity down and the flow down of this brush. Slight texture over the water. just lightly bring it back down here. I feel like Bob Ross explaining what I'm doing. Let's not make it straight, but let's make it kind of go with the waves here. Happy little waves. Well, sad little waves, waves of God's judgment. Oh. All right, I need to take a phone call. Be right back. All right, well, Stephanie's out shopping with the kids, and she was just calling to ask if something was okay to buy. So I'm gonna work on the rain layer. I'll do it in black. actually something that helps is to do this, then this. I lost Instagram when Stephanie called, so I'm just gonna turn that back on live. If anyone knows a better way to make rain, let me know. This is, I guess this is the, as good as any way to do it, I guess. Add like little flicks at the end of some of them. Oh no, I drew all those on the wrong layer. Well, Back to the top. That's probably all right. Probably good. Save. Didn't save it yet. Hey, love the lost video on YouTube. It's our first YouTube comment for the day. RefToons! I'm assuming that's how you say that. spill on my keyboard again. Didn't spill on my keyboard this time. Next time I probably will. Okay, now copy, paste. I'm just gonna, so this is the stage where I'm just kind of testing out how to do some things here. Figure out if this is a good way to layer the rain or not. I'm gonna turn the opacity down, 50, and paste that over there. And then do this. Turn the opacity down to 20. Oh, there it is. Stephanie's calling. One moment, please. All right, let's try this again. Thank you. I just have to delete the extras. Then I'll go in and make little splatter marks wherever the rain is hitting to kind of integrate that into the background a little better. My apologies to Instagram for all of the starting and stopping in the live videos. Water is always super difficult to color. If feel like I've kind of developed a formula for doing it though. You get flat color in, you put a gradient on it, then color the white caps, then I'll throw in some darker colors around, almost like a shadow. Sweet Bert Jr., how long does it take to finish a project? Well, so this one I started a couple days ago with the sketch. There's three stages to each project. Sketch, inks or line art, and colors. And the sketch phase, I feel, actually takes sometimes the longest, and sometimes the color phase takes the longest, depending on the level of detail and what's involved. So typically one of these drawings will take me between 3 to 6 hours, depending on the level of detail and everything involved in it. But that 3 to 6 hours is sometimes spread throughout 3 to 6 weeks. Although right now I'm just kind of doing a sprint on some new RefToons because I feel bad about not putting new ones out recently. Do you have family? Yes, I have family. I have a wife and 4 kids. And RefToons is not my full-time job, so that's also partly why it takes me so long to get new tunes done. If RefToons were my full-time job, I would be doing this every day, and I'd have probably a new tune every few days, as well as other content. But yeah, this is not my full-time job. I'd work full-time as a freelance illustrator. And so I do drawings for my clients during the day. And on weekends and in the evenings, I work on RefToons. Sometimes, if I'm not busy during the day, if I'm slow on work, I will work on RefToons. But for the most part, I keep RefToons to as kind of my side job. Hope one of your children love drawing. Yeah, I have three of my kids actually love drawing and doing crafts. They're always looking for paper, whether it's been used or not. They look for any type of scrap paper or anything to do their little projects on. And so we find papers all over the house from all of their crafting and drawing. So we have a few of them that enjoy drawing. My son does not like drawing. He likes to work with his hands. He wants to be a builder. Oh, you should make them busy. Yeah, I should. I occasionally have them, I have my wife and son occasionally lay in the colors for me. One second. Okay, I'm back. Yeah, I'm not gonna restart Instagram again. Okay, there's our water. Oh God. Save. Now we'll lay in some darker colors. Oops. Turn the flow down, then turn the opacity down. Bring the size up. Oh, I just realized I didn't color him in my other program. Now, what color to make that? Red's probably okay. Thank you. That just means we have to ship something out to someone. We get to ship something out to someone. So, thank you. Part of the sketch is on that layer for some reason. Still a spot right there. So I'm looking at this spot right here. Trying to figure out where it is. Oh, there it is. Oh, I did it on the wrong layer again. Every time. Hey, Matt. How's it going? He says, I enjoy watching your work. I don't do near as much or as nice a job as you, but your procedure isn't very much unlike mine. Thanks for letting us sit in. Yeah, no problem. Enjoy. Sharing my time with you guys. Oh. Stephanie's calling. Hello. Yeah. All right. Big of letters. No. All right, I guess that's a wrap for that one. Thank you all for tuning in, or as my son would say, thank you for ref tuning in. And I'm going to call this one finished. I will schedule it to post probably on Monday. And let's see, we're going to be at the Sing conference in Nashville next month. The beginning of next month, so if you're going to be over there, stop by the RefToons booth, say hi, we'd love to meet you. And the Westminster Illustrated Catechism is ready to be shipped, will be ready to be shipped to us on the 11th, and once we receive that, we will start shipping out all the pre-orders. So thanks for your patience on that. I think that's all I have for you today, so thanks for tuning in, and I hope you have a great rest of your weekend.